Hey, this is Matthew with Another World Terraria. In this series of videos, I'm going to show you how to grow immersed Bucephalandra like a boss. In part one of this series, I'm going to teach you some things about Bucephalandra because the better you understand a plant, the better you're going to be able to grow it. And I'm also going to show you all of my Bucephalandra plants and setups and give you an overview of what you're going to learn. In the remaining parts of the series, I'm going to go into detail about containers, ventilation, substrate, fertilizer, watering, lighting, and other tips and tricks. Subscribe now and click the bell icon so you don't miss future videos. Now I'm going to share some information about Bucephalandra plants because it's going to make you a more knowledgeable and skilled grower. Bucephalandra and many other plants grown in aquariums can be categorized as amphibious plants. Amphibious just means that they're capable of growing both underwater and above water. Here's the proper terminology for underwater and above water growth. When the foliage is underwater and the plant's growing aquatically, the term is submersed. That's the term you'd use for plants grown in an aquarium, for example. When the foliage is above water, the term you're going to want to use is immersed. One thing to watch out for is that sometimes people incorrectly use the word immersed instead of immersed. If you have trouble remembering which is which, here's a little trick that I have for you. For submersed, think of the word submarine, which goes underwater. And for immersed, think of the word emerge, which means to move out of something, as the plant is emerging from the water. Amphibious plants evolved this capability of being able to grow above or below the water due to the conditions of their natural environment. For example, Bucephalandra typically grow in and around streams, rivers, and waterfalls. In some areas, the water level may fluctuate up and down throughout the year, so during a rainy season, the water might be higher, and the plants would typically respond to growing aquatic leaves while submersed for a period of time. When the water level is lower for a period of time, the plants are going to grow immersed foliage. In some places, the plants might also be submersed or immersed year-round, instead of fluctuating from one or the other. One other interesting thing about Bucephalandra is that some of them are categorized as something called a rheophyte. Rheophytes are plants which have evolved to be able to grow in very fast and strong currents of water, where a lot of other plants aren't going to be able to survive. Sometimes some species will grow in more tame water flows, and then occasionally they're going to endure stronger currents of water, like a flash flood, and those are going to be categorized as facultative rheophytes. Rheophyte adaptations typically include fibrous root masses that can grab onto rock faces, strong and tough stems and leaves which can withstand heavy currents, and narrow, streamlined leaves which offer very little resistance to the forces of the water. Bucephalandra often grow in very shady areas, such as the rock faces along jungle streams. You might have noticed that sometimes the plants have an iridescent sheen and a beautiful coloration, often with blue and purple tones. The iridescent appearance is due to some adaptations that the plants have evolved to deal with the limited light levels in these forests and ravines. I'm not going to go into the science of it, but basically, there are structures in the leaves which allow the plant to gather light more efficiently so they can survive in very dim light. In summary, Bucephalandra are amphibious plants and sometimes rheophytes, which can grow in environments where water levels are going to rise and fall, and they can transition either way from immersed to submersed growth. Their habitat is very wet, humid, shady, and tropical. Now that you know more about Bucephalandra and their natural history, you'll be able to make better decisions when growing them, and when I explain my methods, you're going to understand why I do what I do. Let me give you a quick tour of my Bucy collection and setups. I'm not going to go into detail about growing them because that's going to come in the following videos in the series. Here are some of my plant racks, and I've got a few bins here. Let's open up this bin right here that has a bunch of Bucephalandra in it. As you can see, they are happily growing. Got some really nice metallic coloration, some sheen. This is one of my favorite ones right here. It's got all kinds of different colors. It's got like aqua, blue, gold, magenta. It's nice right here. Got a variety of different ones. They're blooming. There's a little mini micro one over here that I got recently. This one's got some really nice blue and purple. And you'll see, I'll try and rotate the bin, and you can see how the colors change. All right, moving down the line, got another bin here. This has some of my most unique Bucephalandra species in it. Some of my favorites. There's that really tiny micro one down there, kind of on the left. This nice big large oval leaf one. That very elliptical thin leaf one right there. The nice oval thicker ones on the right and kind of in the middle and the back. This really nice oblong wavy leaved one. The smaller one on the right with the little ridge down the middle. Really nice stuff. Doing good in here. These ones are not as old as the ones in the first bin. Let's check some more stuff out. We've got a shallow tray here with some smaller species. Got some nice clumps. Pretty tiny bin with some nice little clumps in there. At some point soon, I'll probably need to move these into a larger bin. Got one more large bin to show you. This is a recently planted bin, and this is in fact the one that I'm going to be demonstrating the tutorial with in the following parts of this series. I have this bin with some immersed marsh plants, and you can see I've got a larger Boosie right here in a pot, and the pot is partially in the water there, almost up to the rim.
If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and share, and prepare yourself because coming soon is the rest of the tutorial series for how to grow immersed Bucephalandra like a boss.